Another update on the Hazelwood Open Cut Mine Fire. We're in the third week of fire operations and there's been some great successes by our firefighters that have been fighting this day and night. MFB, CFA, South Australian Metropolitan Fire Service, Tasmania, ACT, Airport Firefighters and Fire and Rescue New South Wales have moved into stations in CFA, all to make this effort a big effort for Victoria, but yet we've still got a fair bit ahead of us. The fire itself has been worked on and worked on well. It's now well past the 50% contained area, but there's still a lot in front of us and we are aiming to get the fire in a contained position in the next 10 days is the hope. However, we're going to be challenged with a couple of days. It looked like it's going to be warm, dry and windy weather, but there might even be a shower of rain in there next week, so that may help us. Rosemary Lister is the Chief Health Officer. Has taken another step about precautionary recommendations to those that live in Morwell South and those that are over the age of 65, under the age of 5, so young children, and also those that have got preconditioned heart or lung conditions or are women that are pregnant. And in saying that, it's the target group that Rosemary's always talked about throughout the fire that need to be looking for respite in the initial stages, and now if they live or work in the Morwell South area are saying it's time to temporarily relocate. That is, leave home and go and live somewhere else for the next week at least. DHS have put in place that people can go and talk to DHS and the City of La Trobe about support, whether they need transport or need assistance with accommodation, whether they need support about their animals, whether it's talking about their medical needs if they're going to relocate, and even if they need financial support, the DHS will be able to provide that under what is seen as the relief arrangements, and really important. So it's something that's really important for the Morwell South community to know that they are the ones that are being asked to reconsider where they are over the next couple of days and to build a plan. And the reason for that is the fact that it's been a constant exposure to smoke that's got particulates in it that EPA have been able to advise Rosemary, as the Chief Health Officer, to say it's probably time that you don't want exposure 24 hours a day. And we've moved on from where she originally said it was just an hour or so to move in and out of Morwell. So it's the next step. It's not an evacuation. It's not an evacuation. If it was an evacuation, that means people are under imminent danger and police would go in and ask them to leave and they'd lock up the suburb. People can come and go as they need. It's a personal choice, but it's a really important message from Rosemary. So I think that's the best way to sum it up for what is now into the third week of this fire. And it certainly had big impacts on Morwell community, and I think we all have got big open hearts to think about those that live in Morwell and hope that we're giving them the right support that they need.